Till when will we differ? There's a book of Sheikh Utaimi. It's available there in the exhibition. Until when will we differ? On page number 36. An Indian asks Sheikh Utaimi a question. In my country, people call towards Ikhwani and Tablighi. Are they on truth or falsehood? Sheikh Utaimi gives the reply. If anyone calls himself as Ikhwani, calling towards Ikhwani, Tablighi or Salafi, he is on falsehood. The question of Salafi wasn't there. Sheikh Utaimi goes out of his way to say that anyone calls himself a Ikhwani, a Tablighi or a Salafi, calling towards him, it is on falsehood, not I. See, Dr. Zakir Naik is nothing in Islam. I am zero. Sheikh Utaimi, mashallah, has a caliber. So I am following the fatwa of Sheikh Utaimi. So any Salafi who points a finger at me will have to point the finger at Sheikh Utaimi. Now all these people on the website, you go, they even say Sheikh Utaimi says call us a Salafi. What he says? Sheikh Utaimi says you should follow the Salafi Salih. But that even I say. So Sheikh Utaimi does not mind anyone following Salafi Salih. But if you call towards saying call yourself a Salafi, he says it is falsehood. Sheikh Utaimi. So Sheikh Nasiruddin Albani is on one extreme, fard. Sheikh Utaimi says it is wrong. But both agree. Sheikh Nasiruddin Albani also says that if you call yourself Salafi, thinking you're superior, then it is wrong. Sheikh Saleh Fawzan also says, if you say I'm a Salafi, I'm superior, then it is wrong. So even these first group of scholars who say calling Salafi is a fard, even they agree, if you call yourself Salafi and say that I'm superior, I will go to Jannah, others won't go, that is wrong. Sheikh Saleh Fawzan, Sheikh Nasiruddin Albani, Sheikh Bin Baz, Sheikh Utaimi, besides saying this, he says you should not call yourself a Salafi. I am not as staunch as Sheikh Utaimi. If you ask me, I said preferably call yourself Muslim. If someone calls himself Salafi, in some cases can be Mubah. Fine, shortcut. I don't say it's haram. But I prefer safe, 100% safe Muslim. The scholars are differing. Should call or not call? If someone is calling as a shortcut, instead of saying I follow Quran, Hadith and Salafi Salih, only till that extent, which is not the case. Most of the people, they say Salafi, safe sect. And all the others will go to Jahannam. So this way it is wrong. For short reason, if you say, I say Mubah, not a Fard. I am more with the fatwa of Sheikh Saleh Munajjid. Sheikh Saleh Munajjid says, if you call for understanding that you do not belong to the innovators, there is no problem. But if someone calls saying I'm a Salafi better, then it is wrong. And he quoted the hadith of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. At the time of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam Madinah, there was a fight between the Ansar and the Muhajirs. So the Ansar said, oh Ansar, come to me. So all the Ansars piled behind Ansar. And the Muhajir said, oh Muhajir, come help me. The Prophet came to know, he said, what is this call of Jahiliya? See, if you analyze, calling Ansar is not bad. Calling Muhajir is not bad. But here they were making groups. Ansar, come and help me. Muhajir, come and help me. The Prophet said it is the call of the Jahiliya. Though Ansar is a good name. Ansar means the helpers. Helper of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Muhajir means those who migrated in the way of Allah and His Rasul. It's a good name, but yet the Prophet said it is haram to identify yourself, I'm superior. So based on this, I don't say Salafi is haram, don't get me wrong, but absolutely safe is Muslim. If you say Salafi and have a little bit of error and, you know, ego and all, problem may go to the, may be dangerous, which the Prophet prohibited. Therefore, safe is call innani min al-Muslim, say that I'm a Muslim. Otherwise, I can say I'm a Pakka Hanafi, Pakka Shafi, Pakka Hamli, Pakka Malki, Pakka Salfi, Pakka Ahli Hadith, no problem. But in label, call yourself a Muslim. I would like to end my talk by giving the opinions in the ending of these great scholars, which will open up your mind. According to those people who say takfir, no takfir, kafir, kafir, Imam Shafi, may Allah's mercy be on him, he said that if calling the names, attributes of Allah, what Allah has given is that. Anything else is haram, is kufr. You can only call to name of Allah what He and His Messenger have given, nothing else. Anything else is kufr. But if someone calls another name in ignorance, then he's not a kafir. Imam Shafi. Shaykh Ibn Taymiyyah, you know what he said? He said, if someone prostrates to a man and he thinks this is his deen, then he's not an unbeliever. Shaykh Ibn Taymiyyah. If someone does shudud to a man, Shaykh Ibn Taymiyyah said, if someone does sajda to a man, to a human being, and thinks it is his deen, he is not an unbeliever until someone explains to him, and yet he's on it. Shaykh Ibn Taymiyyah, what a great personality. Further, if you read Shaykh Shawqani, he said that if someone bows down to anyone besides Allah in ignorance, he is not an unbeliever. Muhammad ibn Wahab, may Allah have mercy be on him, he said that we do not call unbelievers to those people who bow on the idol of the grave of Abdul Qadir, or on the idol of the grave of Ahmad Badawi, or the likes of it. So how can we call unbeliever to those people who do not do shirk? We claim that we are knowledgeable, giving takfir, kafir, kafir, etc. I would like to end with the two hadiths of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in Sahih Muslim, volume number 3, hadith number 4565, that Arfaja, may Allah be pleased with him, he said that the Messenger of Allah said that there will be a time when evil things will happen in a community, and whenever a person disrupts the unity of the Muslim Ummah, strike him with the sword. And if he does not stop, kill him. A messenger said, anyone who tries to disrupt the unity of the Muslim Ummah, strike him with the sword. If he does not stop, kill him. Sahih Muslim, volume number 3, hadith number 4565. I would like to end my talk with the last hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is from Sahih Bukhari, volume number 4, hadith number 3606. I know the lecture is long. Last hadith. Here, Hudhaifa ibn Yaman, may Allah be pleased with him, he says that people like asking to the Prophet what things are good, but I, due to fear, like to ask the Prophet what is evil. And he asked the Prophet that we were in ignorance and evil, and Allah, through His guidance, He brought us to the good. Will there be any evil after this? The Prophet said, yes, there will be evil. Will there be any good after that evil? The Prophet said, yes, but with a little dakhan, with a little evil. So the Sahaba asked, what is that evil? The Prophet said, there will be some people who will call towards things which are not my tradition. The Sahaba asked, after that, will there be an evil? The Prophet said, yes, there will be people who will call you to the hellfire. So Hudhaifa, may Allah be pleased with him, he asks, what should we do? So the Prophet replies, hold fast to the group of Muslims and the chief. So the Sahaba asked, what if there is no group of Muslim and the chief? The reply of the Prophet is, if there are no group of Muslim or no chief, dissociate yourself from all the sects, even if you have to bite the root of the tree until you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that state. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.